Now, NAND gate. The second universal gate is NAND gate. NAND gate means NOT AND gate. NAND, the abbreviation of NOT AND. Okay, NOT AND operation. So what happens? The AND gate connected to an inverter. The output of the AND gate is get inverter. Then the gate is called NAND gate. Okay, so its symbol also like that. Symbol. NAND gate is two input and one output gate. At least NAND gate has two inputs. So here there are two inputs, A and B. Now AND gate with an inversion. This is NAND gate. Okay. Here this bubble represents inverter or NOT gate. Okay. So NOT AND operation is called NAND. So Y equal to the output of this operation is E and B whole complement. NOT AB. Okay. A and B inverter. A and B is the output of AND gate and it gets inverter, complement. Complement AB. This is the NAND operation and its symbol. Now, we want to check the truth table of this circuit, right? Truth table. Truth table. Since this has two inputs, you can write here 2 square means 4 rows in truth table. Okay, A, B, Y. 4 rows. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay. Now what happens? 0 and 0 get inverter. Okay, 0 and 0, 0. Now it get complemented. So you have here high. Now 0 and 1. 0 and 1 gives us 0 and it get inverter. So again high. Now 1 and 0 again high. 1 and 1, 1 and 1, 1, get inverted, so low. So, what is the peculiarity of NAND gate? If both inputs are high, output is low. Otherwise, output is high. Okay, if both inputs are high, then we get low output. So, this is the peculiarity of NOT gate. If both inputs are high, then only low output. Then only output is low, okay? Then only output is low. Otherwise, output is high. You can see here, all other combinations you have high output. This is the property of NAND gate. Okay. Now, we can check the truth table of this circuit with bubbled OR gate. Okay. Bubbled OR gate. Bubbled OR gate. Now you know that OR gate has at least two inputs and only one output. Here also we can write the OR gate with two inputs A and B. Now we call this gate as bubbled core. Bubbled core means input of the OR gate is inverted. That means you have put a bubble here. Okay? Here. Now this is passing through OR gate like this. In its Boolean equation, you can write this as A complement or B complement. Because this is complemented here, A complement, here B complement. This is pouring through this gate, so you have A complement or B complement. Okay, now we can check the truth table of this bubbled OR gate. Okay, truth table of bubbled OR gate. Bubbled OR gate. Since this has only two inputs, you need four rows. So A, B and Y. Okay. 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. These are the combinations. Now we can check here. If both inputs are low, 0 and 0 or no 0, here it becomes 1, here is also 1, so you have output as 1. Okay, so here 1. Now in this case, if A 0 means here it is 1 and B 1 means here it is 0, so you get here output as 1. Now what happens to 1 0 also, you get 1. Now what happens if both are high? If both are high, here comes low. Low or low again becomes low, so you have here low. That these two truth tables are same. Truth table of NAND gate is same as bubbled OR gate. Both are same truth table. That means both are same circuit. If any logic circuits have same truth table, it means that all of them are equivalent. They do same operation. Okay, that means NAND gate is also known as bubbled OR gate. Okay, I can write here NAND gate. This is equal to bubbled OR gate. Okay, bubbled OR. Bubbled OR gate. In its equation form, Boolean equation. You can write this using Boolean equation. That means NAND gate represents A, B or complement. This is equal to A, B or complement equal to bubbled OR gate. That means A complement or B complement. A complement or B complement. Okay. This is called De Morgan's second law. So, either you can use NAND gate or bubbled OR gate. Both are same. So, you can use this relation to simplify logic circuits. When you design a circuit, you can use this NAND gate or bubbled OR gate or NOR gate, it's equal bubbled NAND gate, etc. to simplify the circuit. Okay, so this law is called De Morgan's second law. In the previous case, we learned De Morgan's first law. Okay, now we already learned that this one is a universal gate. Okay, so we want to check how this circuit behaves like a universal gate.
That was what we want to find out.
Okay, so now we can check its TTL, IC circuit, and its equivalent, this fundamental gates. Okay. Now, the TTL of NAND gate is called, two input NAND gate is called IC7400. NAND gate with two inputs, okay, with two inputs. This TTL is just like 14-pin TTL, we are familiar with it. 14th pin is plus VCC and 7th pin is ground. So I don't want to repeat the pinout diagram. Sorry, this pin diagram of this IC7400. But just remember that there are four NAND gates with two inputs in this IC7400. Now we can just prove ourselves that this NAND gate can act as universal gate. That means you have to construct all fundamental gates using this NAND gate. That is the first thing we want to do. Okay? So, as a first one, we can construct NOT gate. NOT gate. First one is NOT gate. Okay. Now, we know that NOT gate has only one input and one output. But our NAND gate has at least two inputs and one output. So, we want to short the inputs. Okay. So, you can draw the circuit like this. Suppose this is the input A. So, you can short the inputs of the NAND gate. And like this. Okay, this is the NAND gate. Like this. So what you get here? If A is here, you get A complement. Okay, Y equal to E complement. That means if A is 0, here you get 1. If A is 1, you get here 0. Okay, so if you have 0 here, both these inputs are 0, 0 and 0, 0, and you get inverted, you have 1. If you have 1 here, both inputs are 1 here, 1 and 1, 1, you get inverted, so you get 0 here. Okay, so this one acts as inverter or NOT gate. Okay, so using a single NAND gate, you can construct a NOT gate by shorting its two inputs to one. Okay, this is the way. Now, just if you want, you can prove the truth table here. Truth table. E and Y. If you give low here, here. If you give high here, low. Okay, this is the truth table. Now, the second one. Second one is AND gate. Okay. AND gate. We have NAND gate. We want to construct AND gate. Okay. How can we construct? Because we know that AND gate, output of the AND gate gets inverted, is called NAND gate. Okay, so if you cancel the inversion of the output, it will give you AND operation. Right, so you have to connect an inverter in its output. Okay, we can do that here. That means this AND gate has two inputs, A and B. Two inputs. Okay. Now, there is NAND gate like this. This is NAND gate. Okay, NAND gate means AB or complement. We need only AB. So, we want to pass this thing once again through a NAND gate. AB. AND gate. Okay, you can check the truth table here. Truth table. Truth table. A, B, and Y. Low, 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 high, high, low, high, high. What happens here? If both are low, here it has high. And it passing through here, get again low. Now, if this one is low and this one is high, and it has output low, it gets inverted, it becomes high, again it becomes low. Again, 1 and 0, 1 and 0. 0 inverted to high, then inverted to low. Now what about 1 and 1? If both are high, if here it comes to high, then it will get inverted low, then get inverted, again inverted high. You can see that this circuit behaves just like the truth table of AND gate. Okay? Truth table of AND gate. Okay, so using NAND gate, you constructed this NOT gate and AND gate. Now what we want to do? Now we want to construct OR gate. Okay, third one, OR gate. Okay, now we already learned that NAND gate is equivalent to bubbled OR gate. That means input itself is inverted and passing through an OR gate. Okay? NAND gate is equivalent to bubbled OR gate. So you have to cancel the bubble in its input. So you want to connect inverter in its input. Right? So I can draw here. That means since OR gate has two inputs, at least two inputs, so here I show you two inputs A and B. Now there is an inverter here. Inverter means we have only NAND gate, so using NAND gate I constructed inverter. Here also I need an inverter, so here also I connected NAND gate like this. Okay, now I get inverter in its input itself. Now I want to give this thing to our bubbled OR gate or NAND gates. Okay. This is OR gate. Now we want to verify this. If this circuit gives you the truth table of OR gate, you can conclude that this is right. Okay. So we can write the truth table. A, B, and Y. Now, you can check it. Suppose both are 0, all the cases I can write here. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Now, if both are low, A low, here it high, here is also high. When it passing through this, it becomes low again. So here low. Now, if A is low, here it is high. If B is high, here it is low. High and low, 1 and 0. 1 and 0, 0, it is inverted, so you have high here. Now what happens? 1, 0. A is high, so it is low here. B is low, so it is high here. 0 or high, 0 and 1. 0 and 1, 0 will get inverted, so you have high here. Now, if both inputs are high, both are low here, when it comes here, low get inverted, you get high. So, what do you get? This truth table is same as
OR gate, truth table of OR gate, right? Okay.
So we can conclude that these three NAND gates using like this can act as OR gates.
So if you have to construct some logic circuit, but you have only ICs with NAND gate, you can do it.
No problem. If you want NOT, AND or any gate, you can construct it using NAND gate.
So NAND gate is also called universal gate. Okay.
A conclusion is that NAND gate is
one of the universal gates. Okay, universal gates.
So we proved that there are two universal gates, NOR and NAND. That means you can construct any gate using NOR. Similarly, any gate using NAND. So these gates are called universal gates.
Okay. Now we can conclude these sessions now. So here we learned two universal gates and its equivalent circuits also. Okay. NOR gates, its equivalent one is bubbled AND gate. NAND gates, its equivalent one is bubbled OR gate. Okay.
So I can sum up all the discussions here within two laws. They are called De Morgan's theorems.
Bubbled
theorems are called De Morgan's theorems.
theorems, you can design any circuits and simplify the circuit. Okay, so if you want to analyze a circuit, you can use truth table. Using this De Morgan's laws and truth table, you can analyze a circuit. In turn, if you have a truth table, you can construct its equivalent logic circuit, that is design. If you have truth table, you can design a circuit for it. It is called design. If you have a circuit, you can analyze, or if you have a truth table, in turn you can build a circuit. These are the two operations you can do in these sections. Okay, so if you have a circuit, you can simplify the circuit using these two laws. De Morgan's first theorem and second theorem, De Morgan's theorems. Okay, so I think I can wind up now. In this lecture, we learned about universal gates. There are two universal gates, NAND and NOR. These are called universal gates because you can construct any gates using a NOR gate or NAND gate. We prove it by drawing AND inverter and NOT, sorry, AND, NOT, OR gates, fundamental gates. If two circuits have same truth table, it means that they are same circuit. Okay. All these are the main things we learned in this lecture. Finally, we conclude our lecture with stating the two De Morgan's theorems. A plus B whole complement equal to A complement and B complement. A and B complement equal to A complement or B complement. These are the two De Morgan's theorems. So, learn well. Thank you.